Before the series begins, I just want to say a little warning, just in case this have a lot of mushing of blood. Well, not a lot, but like enough. Well, if you know what a ghoul is, they like eat humans to survive. So if you think you wouldn't like that or you get tricked by that, please don't watch this video. No further ado, I'll let the video continue. This is a kind of a friend request that I want to say Shigaraki, I don't know how to say Shigaraki video. So I just found out it's Shigaraki, Tomura Shigaraki ex ghoul listener. I've been for so long trying to find like a ghoul listener on YouTube, but there are like one with Shinzo, but I haven't like found many, so I thought they was cool. Name with the description is cool, written by Mochi _X on Wattpad, link in the description below. I'm sorry I'm like bad at Shigaraki's voice, but I'll try my best here. I have a little headache, so this might be even harder. But no further, let's begin with this video. I always feel sad. I'm not a happy person. I hate the feeling of sadness. But just the feeling of being happy isn't something I experience. It happens a few times, like when I met him, and when I get good blood. But other than that, I just feel so empty, so unhappy. Took the glass from the table, was lifted to the rim with the last night's kill. Blood. It trickled down my lips as I took a sip. The blood was dense at best. Not as good as the others, but it's still the only one I could forget. I started to remember the events that had taken place, my first attempt at killing. Why was I thinking of this? Well, my first attempt was, in fact, my boyfriend, and I really missed him right now. I paused, taking another sip, and started to think. I ran down the hallway, not bothered to look behind me because I knew who was chasing me. I could hear the footsteps behind me, and I jumped a fence, climbing over it swiftly and my tentacles throwing me over from a perfect landing. The person behind me didn't have a perfect landing like I did, since I heard them falling over. I tried my best to sprint away, finally turning my head to look at the guy. As soon as my eyes met with his, I was pinned to the wall, trying to use my tentacle to push him off. His hand went to disintegrating it with one touch. Disintegrating it with one touch, I think. It cut it off to stop my body from going away with it. Get off me! I cried, kicking and trying anything to get away. The man wasn't fazed, his red eyes glaring into mine. His forehead sweating, just how long did we run for? Was he already tired? I panted, getting more tired from thrashing about. The guy didn't move. He just kept me there. Let go! I was finally able to land a kick in his area. He fell back, holding his private parts and cursing. Hopping on one leg. I took this chance to make a run for it, but he was faster, grabbing my arm and pinning me to the alleyway wall. My back was against his chest, his breath frantic. Stop making this more difficult than it has to be. He finally spoke, his voice croaky and annoyed. I spun around facing him, sending a right hook to his face and kicking him away. He stumbled, his back hitting the wall. He sent a roundhouse kick at my face. I ducked. The battle of us continued, ending with me taking some of the blood in his arm. He fell to the floor, too tired to get up. I grew two tentacles, letting them carry me away. With his blood in a packet, I couldn't move. I was so tired from fighting for what felt like hours. Finally, it was over. When I got home to my dark apartment, I took a sip of the blood. My mouth was dry from fighting. was filled with delight. I'm not sure if it was because I was hungry and hadn't drank blood in a while, or if it was tasted actually amazing. That didn't matter though, because I was safe and sound home with his blood. I was about to take another drink when I heard someone opening the door. I glanced at the doorway to see the door wide open and Shigaraki leaning against the entrance. "Yes?" I asked, drinking some more of the blood and wiped my mouth with the back of my hand.
Do you not like my blood or something?"
he asked.
"Because all you do is drink everyone else's blood."
I shook my head. "Your blood tastes best. I'm not sure if I can drink anyone else's love."
"Don't know why you do it,"
he inquired, slightly jealous in his voice. What the frick is he jealous about not having his blood taken?
"Because I'm afraid if I drink yours, then I won't be able to stop."
"I muttered, it tastes really good." I laughed nervously.
"Then try some,"
he mumbled. Was that pink on his cheeks? Was he embarrassed? I couldn't say no to this. I took out my syringe and took a few drops, since I wasn't that thirsty anymore. "Thank you." I smiled drinking it. The same sensation came by, my mouth tingling with delight. I felt happy. Happy for once.
Ooh. You guys didn't understand, there was like a flashback, but it didn't say flashback. But I hope you guys understood that. But no further ado, I'll see you guys next video. Bye!